The FEPA Green Book contains baseline studies from Europe, from America, from even the Far East, including studies done in Nigeria, the environment, to be able to tell people that they must do certain things and they must not do certain things. For example, they collaborated with the Germans, the Russians, the Japanese, with the US EPA, Environmental Protection Agency, including the Environment Agency in Germany. And I, for example, was a beneficiary to study environmental journalism in Berlin, in Germany. And that also exposed me, that was in 1990, to be able to see what it is and able to collaborate with some of these experts. It was through the late Peter Prufert, who was my director at the Institute, and Robert Lochner. And they exposed us to various European institutions, various German institutions, including the Atomic Agency in Germany, and also the Basel Convention in Geneva. And the first secretary of Basel Convention, Mr. Pierre Potters, also came to give us lecture, apart from those who taught us in journalism. So we had a world view, a global view, on what reporting, for example, the issue of toxic waste, hazardous materials. So when Nigeria had issues and the Basel Convention on Transboundary Movement of Hazardous Waste came into being, it was nothing new to some of us who had been recipients of scholarship from Germany to be able to report in depth on some of these issues. Basel Convention later on has a linkage center for English-speaking West African countries in University of Ibadan, and Professor Shibanjo, who was a consultant to FEPA, who also went to COCO at the beginning, is the head of Basel Convention. So if I need a story on transboundary movement of hazardous waste and how to confirm it, I know who to call. And it gives me the in-depth analysis. They have all kinds of equipment taken from the UN, from the US, from Germany, from the Swedes. They are there and they are working hard. Then there is Nigeria Institute of Oceanography and Marine Research. They carry out all kinds of studies on atmospheric and water pollution, including the oceans and so on. Even they also network with UNESCO on a regional basis. And they have experts there, from Professor Chidibe, as far back as 88, 89, I was reporting on issues on ozone depleting substances in Nigeria. So these are the people that were doing it, and some of them are still there actively. And the University of Maiduguri, you had Professor Gadzama, who later became the vice chancellor. He was the director of the Institute of Arid Zone. So they were in charge of desertification too. And later on, when I left the Guardian, I went and joined Shane Ogunseyitan, who found the cocoa toxic dump. He was editing the African Science Monitor. And I later on edited the African Science Monitor after he left. So we had all kinds of professors on our board. And Chief M.K. Abiola, who won the election that was annulled, was the publisher of African Science Monitor. And so we had professors in the area of virology, nuclear science, computer science, all of them, including Professor Gazama, and Professor Oyewale Tomori, who is the Vice Chancellor of Redeemed University, they were on our board. So it was so easy to get these experts to give you information on what you need. And because they were on our board, they trusted us with information. They knew we were not going to manipulate any information they gave us. So there was that trust. And we used to meet once in a month in Ibadan, where we look at all the research papers, and which they were giving us freely. But later on, Chief Abiola died, and his children couldn't continue with his dream. So, and I went back to Guardian, reporting for the Guardian. So there are experts in some of these institutes in Nigeria that have done studies that were also financed by the European Union, by the Americans, and other, even the Australians too, financed some of these studies. For example, Federal University of Technology in MENA, in Niger State, specializes on climate change issues. Last COP17 in Durban in South Africa, the woman who is the head, Dr. Apollonia, actually gave a whole lot of information on what the Germans have done to finance the institute, to also have satellite centers in West Africa. So these are experts who have done studies. She did a study on global warming as it affects the northern part of Nigeria about 2 years ago, funded by Heinrich Boll Foundation. So if you come to University of Ibadan, again, apart from the linkage center, they also have other experts doing things in interdisciplinary approach on environmental issues, on climate change issues. University of Lagos too, being close to the lagoon, they have fisheries department, they have zoology department, do things on wildlife. But besides that, interestingly, there are some individuals living in Nigeria that are so interested in climate change studies, or, like I said earlier on, environment is our entire life support system. Mr. Epi Leventis, who owns the Leventis Group in Nigeria, has donated so much money, charity, to protect the environment. He's a lover of birds and wildlife, so he has an institute called Aplori, University of Jos, in the middle belt of Nigeria. And what they do there is just study ornithology in Aplori. And they study bird life, and he even sponsors people to master's and PhD level, Nigerians, to be able to see how the relationship with birds affect our environment. And I need to also stress at this point that, for example, birds are bioindicators. Once there's a problem in the environment, it's the birds that first give the signal, they move. So studies were also done at Ahmad Bello University some couple of years ago that show that about 17 northern Nigerian birds that were known, due to drought, the dry conditions, the desertification, had even moved southwards. So you can see the relationship of birds and people who are interested in also funding science in Nigeria. So all these things have gone into play to make sure that they have the environmental journalist has a fertile ground, good raw materials to be able to disseminate such issues to the public.